Hi, it's Seta here. As you are probably noticed, in many of the videos that I create, I use models from Book of the Dead, which is one of the best package of free assets available in the asset store. The quality of the models is practically on par with the paid ones, the vegetation has a wind effect, and the package contains many different models so you can create various terrain with them. Unfortunately, during installation, we have to install a lot of unnecessary things that we don't actually need in our project. That's why, in this video, I will show you how to prepare a package with just models, so that you can easily use them in any project without installing unnecessary elements. So, let's start. In this tutorial, I will use Unity 22.3.11 with HDRP render pipeline. First, we must open a new project and install a Book of the Dead assets. So go to the packet manager and import this project. First, select the import. And after a few minutes of importing, we got this warning. So select skip and continue import. After import this project, we got a few errors, but don't worry about them, because in this project we just want to select the things we need. Now let's create a new folder and name it Book of the Dead. Open it and create another folder, Wind. Second folder will be Other, and third folder will be Models. Let's expand this Book of the Dead folder and go to the Features, Wind Control, and select Wind Control and Wind Control Helpers. Move these two files to the Wind. Okay. Now let's go to the shaders and select this Book of the Dead and move it to Others. Okay, now let's move to the art and select diffusion profile and then move them to the Others. Let's expand art, select lens flare and move to the Book of the Dead folder. And expand environment, external content, select quick cell and move to models, and then select cliffs, detail map, ground, hive dish, physical object and vegetation, and move them to models. Okay, now select Book of the Dead folder, right click and export package. Deselect all except Book of the Dead folder and click export. To make it easier for us, let's create another HDRP project and import the file that we created before. Just select the file and drag and drop them in the project window. And then select import. In this version of Unity, due to changes in shader graphs, first let's get rid of these shader warnings. So let's find our shaders, and when we click on them, we need to find the shaders with warning, and then let's open them in the shader editor. In the shader editor, we need to find a node with this small hashtag icon, and then click on them and select update. Do the same in other nodes with this warning and then save shader. As you can see, the shader warning has gone, but we must do the same with other shaders. After doing this, all shaders should be warning free. And now we will deal with models. So select models and select cliff and move them to the Book of the Dead folder. Let's select cliffs. Let's change the view mode. And then let's create another folder. Models. And select cave, select material and object, and move to the models. Now we need to select this prefab and move them to cliffs. As you can see, our prefabs unfortunately have error. So first let's open this prefab and find the script, right click and remove component. Now you need to delete this script on all LOD and save prefab. Now our prefab should work fine. Select another folder, select material and object and move to the models and prefab, move to our main folder. And as before, delete our script from LOD and save prefab. Now you need to do it with each subsequent folder. I know it takes some time, but you only need to do it once. Thanks to this, we will not have any problems with those models in the future. And of course, you cannot move the models and only delete the script. But I like when I have all prefabs on one type in one place. When we sort the cliffs, we move to the next folder and create new folder and move the models in the same way. It's up to you how you name and sort them. So you do this with all models that are in the folders except models with vegetation and tree. Because for those models to work properly, we need to do a few more things. Vegetation in the Book of the Dead usually has two prefabs. One without the wind effect and the other with a wind effect. Unfortunately, to see a model with a wind effect, we first have to place a script with this wind effect on the scene. Because the shader is related to it and will not display the model until we have this script on scene. So first, let's move on to our wind folder. Right click, create prefab. Let's name it wind. And then we need to attach our wind control script to our wind prefab. And when we place our prefab on the scene, and when we go to our vegetation folder and place a prefab with a wind effect, all should work fine. Now you can create another folder tree. And in this folder, let's create another folder models, another folder tree. Wind and folder tree, no wind. Now let's expand this folder and go to our models and materials, object and script. Go to models. This prefab, go to no wind. And I'll bake it, go to tree wind. You can decrease this and select all script and object. Like this. Move it to models. I'll barricade hierarchy go to wind, and the others go to no wind. And now you should have all models with no wind effect and all models with wind effect. Do the same with other object. And now let's move on to vegetation. In vegetation, let's first fix three bugs. First, you can find in the shrub models. The first prefab has one LOD not connected. To fix this, let's first open the prefab by double-clicking on it. We can connect it to the LOD group by right-clicking on the LOD bar and selecting Insert Before, and then select LOD 2 and move it to the newly created field. Or we can just remove LOD 2. Now save the prefab. Now let's move on to the bush, and here two prefabs has not connected a material. So let's open the first one. Select LOD 0 and in materials let's assign this material to model. Do the same with other LOD and save the prefab. Now let's open the second prefab and assign material as before. And now prefabs should work fine. Vegetation has another problem that we need to fix. Unfortunately, the wind effect is too strong, and even if we reduce it in our script, it will not look good on our models. Therefore, we must manually set the wind in the materials. Of course, if you like the effect after reducing the wind via script, you don't have to do it and you can go straight to the next chapter. To reduce wind effect, we must find the material, click on it, and go to the wind option. By change the wind mode or increasing or decreasing the wind elasticity and wind range, we can set the wind for the material. To make it easier for you, in the description of this video, you will find a link to the file in which I have included the settings for all the materials that we need to change. After setting the wind effect, all we need to do is sort the models as we did before. If you don't know what to do with any folder, file or model, just create a junk folder and put in there. Don't remove any texture or material, cause many models share different materials with each other. And of course you can delete empty folders after removing models and texture. When you end sorting models, the last thing you must do is right-click on the Book of the Dead folder, select Export Package, and then click Export. After exporting, you can import the created package to any project and use models without unnecessary add-ons. And that's all for this tutorial. I hope it was useful for you. If you have any questions, just comment me below. And till the next time. See ya.